Hello, I'm Jackie. I'm Morpeth Methodist Church's Children's and Families Worker, and today we're going to be doing some rainbow crafts. If you have a look on our Facebook page, you will see instructions for how to make a rainbow bubble snake, and that's a good one to try at home. It does require quite a bit of puff though when you blow in the bubbles. Now, the other crafts we've been doing today are rainbow straw blowing, okay, and marbling. So I've had a go at making some marbled rainbow paper. Marbling is a Victorian technique, and you'll find lots of videos on YouTube about how to marble at home. Some of those require, you know, quite top-end equipment, marbling trays, inks. I think some of the traditional marbling is done with seaweed. But I've had a go at home this morning doing it with some vegetable oil or sunflower oil and a shallow bowl. First of all, you fill the bowl with water, so it's fairly full. Add a few drops of the sunflower oil. And what you should get is a bowl filled with a mixture of oil and water. You can stir it around with a spoon, which breaks it up into lots of different bubbles. After that, you can take a plain piece of paper, dip it into your sunflower oil and water, lift it out, and it should have picked up the outline of the oily bubbles. Now you can see probably better if I hold this one up to the light, the bubble effect, okay? There's two ways of getting the colour onto your marbled paper. You can start to drop acrylic or powder paint into the bottom of your bowl. It will sink. So then you will have to re-dip your paper, press it down to the bottom, and then as you lift it out wet, you should have picked up some of the paint. That's quite a good one to experiment with. Another idea is to use a syringe, like a toy syringe from a nurse's or vet's set. If you're using a medicine syringe, make it very clear to children that this is not to be used for medicine, that this is used for paint. Perhaps tape it round so it looks different, so there's no confusion between your medicine syringes and the ones that you are using for play, because that's really important. So if you take your medicine syringe, you can draw up a tiny bit of paint and then very, very carefully drip it onto your wet paper. I'm not going to do that because I don't want paint everywhere. As you can see, there's a little bit of dripping, but that's a really good technique to try also. And once they're finished, you can either put them outside in the sunshine to dry or pop them into the oven on a low heat. So it's a really good, quite messy activity, but a good one to experiment with at home. I hope you have fun doing it, and I'll see you next week for music and more crafts. Bye-bye.